whatever you have discussed here or heard, taken in your mind, prepared your mind to come to the conclusion with regard to the peace, stability and sustainable development in the eyes of the rule of religion. Now, if we think about the peace, what is peace? In my mind, the peace is a thing which is calmness in your mind, which will not allow you to be ever perturbed with anything which is happening outside. That's the peace in your mind. Now, the sustainable development, stability, rule of religion in respect thereof, according to me, is really depend upon the first word. First word used in this seminar is peace. What is sustainable development? According to me, it's a development which meets the present day needs without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. And there are three aspects of such sustainable development. One is economic, second is environmental, and most important, and not the least, social impact. Economic development, economically sustainable system must be able to produce goods, services on a continuing basis to maintain manageable levels of governance and external debt of the society. An environmentally sustainable system must maintain a stable resource base, avoiding over-exploitation of renewable resource systems or environmental sink functions and depleting non-renewable resources only to the extent that investment is made in adequate substitutes. Then, and very shortly I'll come to social. A socially sustainable system must achieve distributional equity, adequate provision of social services, including health, education, gender equity, and political accountability and participation. These are the basic features, according to me, which plays a role for sustainable development of the society in respect of the generations which are coming, and in fact which are still we, including ourselves. This sustainability introduces many potential complications to the original simple definition. The goals expressed or implied are multidimensional, raising the issue of how to balance objectives and how to judge success or failure. In the real world, we can rarely avoid trade-offs, and we can maximize only one objective at a time. The strongly normative nature of the sustainable development concept makes it difficult to pin down analytically. Nonetheless, the three principles outlined above do have resonance at a common sense level. They satisfy the criteria set forth earlier for a powerful, easily grasped concept which can have wide applicability. Surely, if we could move closer to achieving this tripartite goal, the world would be a better place, and equally, surely, we frequently fall short in all three respects. It may be easier to identify unsustainability than sustainability, and the identification of unsustainability can motivate us to take necessary policy action. But before we can attempt to balance these different perspectives, we need to understand them and explore the internal logics. Each of the three areas is commonly referred to as a system: economic systems, environmental systems, and social systems. I would rather place more stress on social systems, which really comes out of this religion, which has a definite role to play in people's search of world peace, and the moral principles and values contained in the teachings of great religious teachers are essential factors for the reduction and ultimate eradication of greed, hatred, and delusion, which form the root cause of various conflicts and wars. I will now focus on why and how religion and violence are associated. As we, every day, if we look after here and there, we'll be able to find out that the present age to promote peace and to resolve conflict. I believe that the religion and violence are associated with each other for two reasons. People fall prey to the plan of economic fundamentalism, and people do not know their own and others' religion. That's the main thing. A person who is drinking water, he is telling it is water. Some person's telling it as pani. Some person's telling it as jal. Many other form of the thing, we may call it in different way, but the thing is same. Just the concept of religion is same, and that is only one. But the belief, so far we are concerned, we have to have that belief in our mind. And if we have belief on ourselves, if we look within us, then we can find out what is the thing which we are telling as a religion, religion, and religion. According to me, every soul has a definite within the mind, the divinity. And that's the reason we try to go and find out, and goes not by the head but by the heart, to look after the people and to do good to them. If that is there in any person, that is really pricking your divinity to do something good to the others, and that's religion. I may be wrong according to your thoughts, but I believe in that, and I really want to believe till my last breath. What we are witnessing today is that the resurgence of religion is lesser than that of communalism, where a community of believers not only has religious affiliation but also social, economic, and political interests in common, which may come in conflict with the corresponding interest of another community of believers. Indeed, most secular analysts and progressive commentators have traditionally sought to uncover factors other than religion as the root cause of an ostensible religious conflict. The real cause of conflict between groups has been generally identified as a clash of economic interests. Explanation embraces some versions of a class struggle between the poor and the rich. That's the main thing we forget every time, and we say religion, religion, and religion. I may have a religion, X may have a religion, Y may have a religion, but the ultimate goal is nothing but the same path which we'll follow to lead and to go at a point. Paths may be different to reach there. There may be many roads to reach there, but the things are same. Ultimate thing is to reach there, to have peace in your mind, be calm and quiet, and go for the religion and do good to the others, because the God has given you two hands. One hand you can subtly use for your own families and for yourself, but why you not catch hold of the others with another hand which has been given to you? So I would request you that it would be nothing but togetherness with your two hands. Thank you all.